Thank you. Thank you. Just believe it. What a finish from Hivi. In the space of less than 30 seconds, it was Divo Barbi that were looking like the team to score the first goal and just caught off guard. Divo Barbi hit themselves at the back. Such a disappointment, but this is what counter-attacking in football can do. You commit all men forward. It all started in the form of a free kick. It all started in the form of a free kick as Divo Barbi committed their man up front, and the ball somehow Toka heading it on towards the goalkeeper. It hits the post and Taiku with the all-out attack. That's how they got the first goal. So lightning counter-attack from Taiku, and 1-0 it is to the home team. Set piece chance for Taiku, but it was two players that collided. That could have been 2-0.
Thank you. Is that anything different?
This is Kakai. Kakai with a good through ball to Puloka. Puloka sends one in, and Lijan gathers the ball second time. Toika. The whistle has gone up. And referee just making the stance clear on that.
No fighting, bad manner.
Vigito with the header, now Toka. Lelen to Vigito. Lelen will gather the ball. Alapu. For 17, Yuben. Stolen away from him. Toka. This is still Toka. Referee not given anything on this. Up against Hevi. Cleared. Now Ate can hear it. Lexi. Toka. Toka to Toika. Given away. Hibi. Kakai. Kakai with the shot. Deflected for a corner. Barbie playing some dangerous football at the back, giving the ball away. Taiko will get their second consecutive corner kick. Corner kick this time, coming in low.
Oh,
Hawkeye looking to play 1-2, but not getting it. Toka. First, and clears the ball away as Kakai was lurking to get in to try and snatch the ball from him.
Hey, be a smart guy!
Shot. This will be a corner kick. With the corner kick, and the keeper does well to come out of his line. Toka with the shot, and it's a goal from Toka. What a super finish from Toka. What a shot. And Toka, who could have nearly scored in the early stages of the game, has finally got his goal in the score, in the scorecard, and what a way to finally come back in this match. And with that, it's the cooling break, and at the break it is 1-1 to Divovar B Wolves after Hero came on to the team. It's provide them with a lethal attack. We'll see you soon after the break. Okay, to resume after the break, it is 1-1. Courtesy of the goal from Toka. Give it to Hero. Now Toka. Now Toka to Hero. Hero dispossessed. Here is Toka. Still Toka. Ayu. Ayu not getting the connection that he wanted. And looking for Ayu. Now this is Kakai. Kakai to Puluka. Now Hivi. Hivi with the chase. Hivi puts one ball in and Lijan saves the day. Pikito. Hero. Ayu, Toka. Toka can distribute the ball to the wide right side. This is Hero. Hero leaves it for Ayu. And Ayu, what a chance. Could have used his left foot to shoot at the goal, but choosing to do it is right, so not testing the goalkeeper. Kekre, now Kakai. Kakai plays it to Hivi. This is Hivi. Still Hivi. Good work from Hivi. Kekre. Ate. Hero is challenged by the midfielder. Kakai. Good work from Kakai. And the clearance is made. Now Vikito will take the long throw in that he does. Ayu gets the connection. And Deepu Barbie Wolves get the throw in. Alapu. Alapu to Lelen. Lelen takes a shot. One of the different Barbie players. And Nukshi is brought down. That's the reason the whistle has gone up. Vikito can lunge it here this time. This is five over the wall. Daniel. Daniel sends one in. 22. Ate. Ate with the shot. What a chance for Ate to make it 2-0. Luka, Lelen. Lelen back to his right. Right back. Daniel. Kekre. Alapu. Good. Good defending from the Deepu Barbie Wolves. Long throw in from Vikito, and the ball has gone over the top of the crossbar, and Deepu Barbie survives. There's two. Alapu. Puluka. Lelen. Lelen looks for Vikito. Vikito does well. And Mono can clear it. Go into Deepu Barbie. Referee Ren has signaled us for the added time of 2 minutes left in this game. The scoreline is still 1-1. Taiku giving away their lead as Toka scored the equalizer at the closing stages of the cooling game. Mono. Kakai prepares himself for the shot. What a shot from Hivi. Vikito is blocked to the way. Toka. Toka versus Kekri. Ate, Toika. Vikito. This is Sujimo.
Ya le dije, "Dime, ¿cómo me vive?" ka mari jo
Alaku TV Now corner kick for Taiku. Pressure on the wall. This is 17-17. He lunges the ball at the back of the goalpost. Given the goal scorer of the second goal. If you have just tuned in, it's 2-1 to Thaiku. Just beaten down and out. That is the reaction from the goalkeeper. Such a wonderful goalkeeper. Homka could not contain the shot. And what a goal. The player to score is no other than jersey number 20, Mr. Jami for the Difubar B Wolves. Line is 2-2 as Jami with a wonderful free kick equalizing in the game again. This is Ayu. Now Toka up against Homka, and Homka is there to save the day this time. Tight contest between both the teams, and Lijan does well to keep the ball away. Lejan can call. Player that has just scored the goal in the form of a free kick is there to take another free kick. It comes, but this time a little way over the top. By the defense line of Difu Bar B. Now their throw-in specialist. It is a plus point to have a long throw specialist in your team when you have situations like this. Oh, what a block! That is an absolute. Yeah. Toka is down on the ground, pushed from behind from Hebe. We have another player in the third as well. Lelen can clear it. Scoreline is still 2-2. This is quite a contest for both teams. Looking to go up the table. Toka. Hero. Irango with a little push from behind. Minhao, the player that is come on. Toka. Back to Toika. Still Toika. Hebe. Jersey number 2 will be replaced by jersey number 16. Biloka. That's the defender. Player coming off is Lanu, who makes way for his defense counterpart. Lanu looked to have taken a knock. Lakshi gets the header. Ayu. Lakshi. Hero. Alapu. Puloka. Sujimong. Sujimong looks for Kakai. Now 5. This is Vikito, the long throw-in expert. Danger is cleared. Toika. Still Hero. Hero does well to retain the ball. Hero tries a shot, but it is wide off. Now Kekri. Kekri to Elmenhau. Elmenhau looks for support. Will get Kekri at the center of the park. Good work for Puloka. And Puloka will keep the throw in as Toka just pulls his jersey from the bag. is Abum. And Lee Jan with a powerful clearance. Taiku FC with another chance with the long throw in. This is Vikito. It's cleared away by the man in blue, the Skitri. Ritsu. Still Ritsu. Football to Hiro. Was right from Hiro, but the execution was poor this time, or that could have. Had it gone at the back of the net, it could have been 3-2. Now this is Taiku. Vikito with the throw in. Kakai gets the header. And goal kick points the referee. Nothing to separate both the sides as we witness this tightly contested match. Kikito heads it back to his goalkeeper. Kakai. Misconnection from Kakai. TV. Daniel is there before Hivi can sprint. Taiku FC Vikito with the long throw in again. Two lunges the ball forward. He looks to be in some kind of pain at the moment. Well, good news, Lee Jan is up. The goalkeeper for for Diffenbach B Wolves. Now Kaka is being replaced. It's Mugapu to join the action for the remainder of this match. The scoreline is 2-2 at the moment. This is Hero. Push at the back, Taiku will keep the free kick. It's Abung over the set piece. Now, Diffenbach B must defend well. The Reds looking dangerous. Have mostly older men in the box. Goalkeeper Lee Jan is there yet again. Too quick for Hero to control the ball. This is Viloka. Hero up against Alapur. Still Hero. Hero puts one in. And Toka just slashes the ball over the top. What a chance for Diffenbach B Wolves. And the chance goes begging. Thank you. Now a chance for the Difubar B Wolves. This is Tohika over the set piece. Tohika, the header is there. It's good block from the goalkeeper. Lekshi to drive one in. It is. Out for a goal kick. So scoreline is still 2-2. If you have just tuned in, it is nail-biting closing stages of the game. Dijan is there to collect it. Now Hivi. Hivi to Kekri. It's cleared by Atik. Jersey number 14 makes way for Senti. Jersey number 18, Senti the striker. This is Taiku over the set piece. That's a push, says the referee. Thank you. number two with the set piece as referee signals for additional time of 4 minutes. Ball is released quickly to Ayu. Now Nukshi. Nukshi to Hiro. This is Hiro. Still Hiro. Less than 4 minutes into the game. It could be anyone's game. It is 2-2 here at Taiku local ground. This is Kekri now. Kekri to Alapu. 22. Cleared away. Goalkeeper lunges it. This is Senti. Senti gets his first touch. Still Senti. Elmenhau. Still Elmenhau. Chance for Taiko FC. Goal kick. Now this could be the last action of the game. The scoreline is still 2-2. Kekri now. Elmenhau. Still Elmenhau. Not she can clear it. This is Poluka. Running short of time for both teams if they have to take.
No. No, huh? Come, just to the team, come this evening.
Cleared away by Ayu, and that is the end of a tightly contested match between Taiko Youth FC and Difupar B. And both teams share 1 point each, nothing to separate both sides, and a good game of football has just come to an end. And we look forward to the next match.
He making the little.